Capricorn, it's me, Stormy, and here's your horoscope for August 2018. So before we jump in, Capricorn, I have an awesome special and opportunity for you to take the Astrology 101 or 101 and 102 courses that I have for an absolutely discounted rate. I've got a whole video on the channel in the playlist about it, so check it out. You can get registered down below. Classes kick off in September, okay? All right, speaking of doling out a little bit of money, this is actually an interesting month, I think, for you, Capricorn, because we've got not only still a bunch of retrograde energy that we're coming into the month with that is a continuation kind of what has been, right? But also two of the retrograde planets, being Mars and Mercury, are actually on that second and eighth house axis, which is called the financial axis. So we know that there are things going on with your finances. The other part I think is really critical to understand is that there could be something going on with your value, your esteem, and your intimacy, to include maybe something in that sex life. You know what I mean? Maybe you've been trying to advance towards somebody and you haven't quite gotten there. You know what I mean? All of these things are kind of set back and a little frustrated at this time. Now, I will tell you a couple things with finances. Whenever our financial axes are being triggered, what we want to do is be mindful of the budget, okay? You want to be mindful of your money. Now, because the eighth house is involved here and Mercury is retrograde there, plus we're going to have a solar eclipse happening over there, it is possible that all of that looking back energy is telling you to relook over your budget, relook at loans, student loans, debt, any of those things, to see how you can make progress going forward. Right now it's more of a time to review, maybe reviewing ways that you can make money, that you can stimulate your income. You know, should you buy that second business? Should you do something in this direction? Should you change careers? Things like that could definitely be looking up for you, and you may be looking around at them this month, okay? Now let's jump in here and break this month down by date and see what else is going on. Right at the beginning of the month, jumping in, kicking off, on the 6th, we've got Venus entering into the sign of Libra. So this is hitting at the top of your chart, which is absolutely beautiful because this signals a little bit of a career change. But what it does is Venus is very, very magnetic energy. So this could be bringing new opportunities your way, right? This could be bringing people your way. This could be bringing a job opportunity or a potential job or career opportunity. And I say job or career because this could be, remember, we're thinking in terms of like that soul level calling, right? What's the soul level calling? What are you trying to move out into the world? Maybe you're trying to get a different reputation, a different status in the world. And this energy is really very helpful. This is also great energy for things like a raise. Okay, so this could possibly be something that's happening there as well. Now on the 7th, we've got Uranus taking a retrograde in the sign of Taurus. Now this is interesting because what it does is it goes back into your fifth house. Now this is a house of true love, romance, children, expression, risks, investment, fun, all of those things. And with Uranus trekking backwards, sometimes what Uranus does, he actually is more helpful when he goes retrograde, because instead of creating all this external change and instability and things like that, what he does is he creates the needed energetic shift and break free energy within you that you will change it from here into your external world. So whatever you've been trying to gain that level of freedom, that personal freedom from, and I do think for so many of you, it's this idea of what things were. I really feel like, Capricorn, this is a great place for you to come current with the reality of who you are today so that you can live that very, very fully. So that Uranus retrograde helps to shake out some of the stuff that doesn't need to be in that space for you anymore. So really lovely. Now, on the 11th, we've got this new moon partial solar eclipse happening in the sign of Leo. Now this is happening in that eighth house space, which is the same place that Mercury is retrograde in. So we do have this combination of energies where this new moon, this is our new beginning, right? We plant the seeds of intention at the new moon so that we can begin something new. And we don't know what's going to happen when we move it forward. We're just planting the seeds of intention so we can see how it potentially will work out. And we agree to move forward with whatever comes, right? Now, having this here with Mercury and Mercury's retrograde, I'm telling you, if there's been something weak in your intimacy, if there's been something weak in your finances, if you've still had just like a load of debt or something like that going on, this is a great time where you'll be going back over it. Now, for a few of you, I do think too, there's this potential for maybe you have money owed to you and it's coming to you as well. So any of these things, kind of keep an eye out. But what you can be assured of is that Mercury is gonna come out of retrograde on the 19th, and then that solar eclipse energy, I think you'll get to feel it a little bit more in terms of moving the energy forward, okay? Because the eclipse is gonna pan out for about 6 months. Now, as we get to the 12th of the month, first of the things that are happening is that Mars, like I said, as we come into the month, is actually in Aquarius, so that second house. But from August 12th to the 27th, Mars is still in retrograde, but it's going to stop and come retrograde into your sign. So when Mars is retrograde in your sign, one of the things we can feel is kind of exhausted or a little energy drained, or like, I don't have my mojo. I don't have my get up and go. You know what I mean? And what I would tell you is, if you feel like your energy is low, don't try to force. You're not going to be able to force. You're not going to be able to push. This is not going to be the time, as we close out this month, to try and push yourself in a whole bunch of different directions. If the energy is asking you for a slowdown, give into it, because there's maybe something you need to see while you're slowing down and reevaluating yourself. I told you, there's a lot of you coming current with who you are, what you're about, and where you're going right now, that this is actually probably going to be a very welcome energy for you to kind of retreat into. Now, on the 19th, Mercury comes direct there in the sign of Leo, so in the 8th house. So there we go. Monies that are maybe owed to you, things like that, decisions you need to make around your finances, decisions around intimacy, decisions around studying or following your passion could definitely be things that are alive, and you're able to make some solid judgment about how to move those things forward, to communicate about those things. You know, let's say that you had a loan and you needed to talk, or goodness forbid, the IRS or some government agency. This would be a great time to have those conversations, and definitely on board to sign new contracts after the 19th of the month. On the 23rd, the sun is going to enter into Virgo, and when we get to the 26th of the month, we've got a full moon happening in Pisces. Now remember, the full moon says that something's going to be ended. We need to acknowledge something, or we need to adjust something, and this is going to be happening in your third house. So this is a very mental energy, but it's small mind. This is core level, tiny details about things. So this could be a contract. This could be you're selling something, you want to buy something, you've wanted to buy something, or you've wanted to sell something. Maybe you're studying something and you need to make an adjustment here. Definitely adjustment to your thinking and the way that you are communicating. So one of the things I think about for you too, Capricorn, is that through the month of July, one of the things that could have happened is you could have relationships that fell out or fell off, or you decided to be in those relationships differently. And by the end of August, what's happening is, in terms of your communication, you're even talking and networking with different people. So something to kind of watch, and let me know how that pans out for you. Now, as we get to the 27th, Mars is going to turn direct. Thank you. Hallelujah. We get some forward motion from our energy planet, and it's turning direct in your sign. So we'll be able to turn back up the volume, right? And get a little bit more energy and a little bit more oomph to be getting some things done. So you can start to find yourself at the end of the month, definitely moving through and into September, having a lot more energy to move some things forward, to move you forward, and to participate in the world with all this information you've gathered from the past about what doesn't fit anymore and where you need to adjust so you can be on track with where you want to go, right? So you'll have the energy to move these things forward at that time. So, plus, Mars being direct gives everybody their libido back, usually, depending on your chart. So the libido can also not just be used for sex. It can be used as this fire that just kind of burns within you and gives you a little bit of passion to get some things done. So I really like that. Your passion's coming back online, Capricorn. Hold on, okay? All right, Capricorns, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. I hope to see you in the astrology classes. And either way, I love you a ton, and I will see you next month, okay? Bye!